say. Again, I'm a bit of a doofus. I know I just saved, but you can never be too careful in one of these types of games, considering a choice can make you get a bad ending. So yeah, a lot of messed up shit going on around here. No, it looks like everything's still closed off. Weird. Well, the only thing I can kind of think of is that blocked off, closet there, but I don't see why that would be open at this point. Well, I'll go check it out anyway. Won't hurt, I guess. Or maybe it could hurt, knowing this game. Oh dear. So yeah, you can understand why I have no sympathy for that motherfucker in any way, shape, or form. So it kind of makes me wonder why she was running, but I think I know why. I mean, the guy's obviously a scumbag. He was probably trying to... That must be the last part of Naho's little notebook. I wonder if it works the same as the victim's notes. But anyway, like I was saying, that principal was obviously a scumbag, so he was probably trying to do something inappropriate. And you all know what time it is. That's right, it's time to save scum. Alright. Naho's notes, 5 of 5. The pages are all blank. Huh. Okay. I guess it's not like the victim's memoirs. Ugh, these papers. Just looking at them makes my head throb. It's like they're somehow filled with emotion. Like Naho's feelings have been projected onto them. I can smell him. I'm getting closer. Soon, I'll be with him again. Oh, just to, I think I know what this is leading to. You remember the second tape? You couldn't hear it because apparently some of the sound effects are tied to the voice track. But she was breaking into wherever Kibiki was hiding. Probably in the closet. She was basically pounding on the door to get to him, and she was speaking in this really dual-toned, like, exorcist shit voice, you know? Soon, I'll be with him again. The letters are just appearing on these blank sheets of paper. It's like they're being written right now in front of my eyes. My consciousness is fading. My hands are jet black. But I'm all right. I'll be with him again soon, after all. Where you'll apparently kill him, Naho's note, 6 of 5. I found you, Kibiki. I found the room you ran to. Wait for me. So yeah, I imagine the darkening took hold of her too, 7 of 5. I missed you. I'm going to hug you now. Whatever of 5. Everything has gone dark. My body is a black mist. Was she the one that attacked us in the nurse's office? Oh no, that doesn't seem right. I mean, that thing said, "My sweet Sachiko, if you come back to me," or whatever, something like that. But yeah, I think that's what's happened. This darkening, as Kibiki called it, has affected her completely. What the hell? Naho. Okay, that's interesting, but... Now what? This is gonna be me wandering around going, what am I doing again, isn't it? Expulsion to all trespass. I still know what the fuck's up with that. Or I don't know what's up with that, I should say. So the question is, what do I do now? I mean, I don't want to head there just yet because I have no idea what I'm doing. There being the incinerator. I mean, I don't want to end up where I was before, not being able to progress the story. There was this flash. Did that mean anything? Did something open up then? Well, I'll take a poke around. Again, I might have to pause. I don't want you guys to get too bored after all. Hey, look at this. Yeah, I did. God, there are a crap load of freaking I'm drawing a blank. Name tags. Jeez. In this chapter, there's an option to look at them. I mean, look at how many different schools. Jeez. So, okay, I'll switch over and see if anything opened up or anything like that, you know. Nothing this way. Yeah. So yeah, fun times all around. I mean, I don't see the point of going back to the annex. I mean, I've been everywhere but the art room. So, yeah. Can I use this? Nope. Why is there a ladder leading up from there into the... You know what? Video game logic, I'm not gonna argue with it. I wonder if anything will happen if I'll click on that bathroom stall that she was hiding in. Doors affixed to the wall, yeah. Can they meet up again and exchange information? One way to find out. Oop, wrong way. And of course I'm on the wrong floor. Oh man. This must be so entertaining for you guys to watch. I mean, me bumbling around. Note the sarcasm. And if this is boring, I'm sorry, but yeah. If nothing comes up from me having to meet up again, well, I'll just pause the video. Oh dear, oh dear. Speaking of people I don't have sympathy for, Kizumi. Yeah, that's his name. I forgot for a minute. The guy who got turned into a real-life anatomical model. Okay. Well, I guess I'll pause the recording. Hopefully I'll be back in a... Well, to you, I won't be all that long, but hopefully it doesn't take me forever and a day to figure things out. Be right back. Alright, I'm gonna try to see if anything has changed now that I've done things in what seems to be the proper order. Here we go. Something wrong? This room seems to be set up for black magic or witchcraft or something. How do you figure? I don't see anything out of the ordinary. What, you don't see the giant fucking pentagram on the floor with the runes and shit? I don't know. Come on, we should keep moving. You said there was a presence out by the incinerator, right? All right, let's go. Actually, how about you go on ahead and I'll catch up with you? Actually, you know what? I want to see what happens when I pick the other option. You go on ahead. Yeah, the same thing happens. Actually, how about you go on ahead and I'll catch up with you? Okay. Don't take too long. Huh? What was that voice just now? I didn't say any of that. Shinazaki, hey! Shinazaki! And that's him locked out. What? What is it? I'm locked out. No. God, no. Kishinuma! Kishinuma! Am I trapped in here? No, the other way out seems to be open. Open up! Come on! Kishinuma, yeah. Somebody open the damn door. Come on, please. Yeah, we've all seen this scene before, so I'll just kind of... I'm very glad to see you alive. Yes. Oh, heartfelt reunion that's going to be fucking ruined in a little bit. You're injured. Yeah, I'm surprised she's able to move around as well as she is, considering what landed on her. Earthquake! She's up! Ah! Yep. Yep, seems to be the same. Quickly, grab hold of my leg! Climb up my body! Yeah. Actually, you know what? I'm not gonna have you guys sit through any more of this, so unless something changes... And we're back. I guess we'll see if anything's different. I mean, why are you saying who? That's the principal. You should know that. It's the principal. Exactly. So I guess we'll see if anything's different now that they're going into the incinerator. I'm sorry if I seem exasperated, but... It's been a rough couple of days. What's that? Looks like somebody threw something in there that's very yellow. You can see a yellow ribbon a few feet in, covered in soot. I think it's the ribbon from Sachiko's dress? But it's just out of reach. Arms not quite long enough. Does anyone actually do that in real life? You know, when they're straining for something, or it's just straining in general, I don't know. Anyway. And of course, from the darkness within the incinerator, the figure of a girl can faintly be seen. She's squatting with hands around her knees. Whoa, it's Sachiko. Upon meeting your gaze, she spins in place and begins crawling deeper into the machine until she vanishes from sight. What the hell? You know what? I don't even know why I'm recording this part. I'm going to get to the choice. You know what? And we're back! I finally broke down and went back to the incinerator. Thing is... I kinda see what's gonna happen if I turn back. Hey, can we just go back? I have a really bad feeling about this. Ugh, yeah, okay. You able to turn around? Just take your time. Uh-huh. Watch it be a bad end. Or not. I don't know, though. I really feel there's...